Hi guys, my name is Elma and today I'm doing a plant collection video. I'm just gonna go over the plants I have in my home and then also some of the new plants that I picked up for 2018. So if you're interested, then keep on watching. Okay, so first plant that I'm gonna go through, and I have like my plant care notes here, so if I'm looking down it's because I'm referencing my notes. So the first plant that I wanted to talk to you guys about is this lovely peperomia, and this is a variegated version. Absolutely love this plant. This one's new. I picked this up from Home Depot, and so this plant likes bright and direct light, preferably a west or east facing window, and you want to allow the top 50% of the soil to dry before you water it again. And this one is a good one to water from the bottom, so really beautiful plant. As far as the pot goes, it does like to be root bound in a small pot, so you don't have to pot this one right away. The leaves are poisonous, so if you have any pets, definitely keep them away from this guy. But I absolutely love him, the pot I picked up from Michael's. Okay, next plant I have, also a new plant, if you can guess, is an African violet. Absolutely love this plant. I really like the leaves on this, like how thick they are. And then right now it's in bloom, absolutely beautiful blooms. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh my God, I love it. The pot I got from World Market. So this likes bright and direct light, preferably an east facing window. It likes for its topsoil about 1 to 2 inches of the topsoil to dry out before watering. And you can't get any water on the leaves. It doesn't like any water on the leaves, so it's preferable that you water this one from the bottom. It doesn't like any water that contains chlorine or fluoride in it, so do water this one with distilled water or tap water, but it has to have been like sitting for like a day to 2 days before you use it. And it doesn't like water that's passed through like a water softener either, so keep that one in mind. And as far as the flowering goes, you want to remove the dead blooms right away. And it said on there when I was doing my research that if you let it, the soil stay kind of on the dry side, that it kind of encourages the plant to bloom more. And then I also read that if once in a while you want to remove the bottom leaves to encourage growth like on the top leaves. So, but I haven't tried that because it's still a new plant to me, but I absolutely am enjoying having him. And then the next plant that I absolutely love is my spider plant. So my spider plant, and it comes in this really cute stand. I also got this from the World Market. I'm just gonna move this aside for now. So love this plant, super cute, right? And so the care instructions for this plant, it likes medium to bright indirect light. It likes for the top 50% of the soil to dry out before watering him. And another plant that's kind of sensitive to certain types of water that's high in salts and chemicals, it causes the leaves to turn brown. So you want to use distilled water for him as well. Or you can use tap water, but let it sit for a day or two before using it. And as far as the pot goes, it likes to be root bound. It encourages to get the little baby spider plants, so this one doesn't have to be repotted right away, and the leaves are not poisonous either, so I love that. It does like, it does prefer humidity, but it still does okay, so yeah, I love this guy. And I have a pothos here, really cool planter. This is from Target, and this pothos is huge and bushy and full, and this is a Marble Queen pothos. Absolutely love this guy. He's so big. I actually took some cuttings from him already and I'm trying to propagate it, so we'll see how I do. And he has like some new leaves that are coming up, so that's cute. So this one, with the pothos, there's different types of colored leaves. The lighter the leaves, the more light it needs. So I keep him in a bright indirect light, and I allow the water to, or the soil to dry out about 50% before I water him. And they like to be root bound as well. So the leaves are poisonous, so you have to be careful with this one as well. But I absolutely love that, you guys. Okay, so the most popular houseplant and my personal favorite is the Monstera Deliciosa. I love this plant. This is a baby plant. I have another one downstairs and it's much larger than this guy and he has split leaves already. This one is still growing and he doesn't have any split leaves yet, but he has three new growths there, so I'm hoping that someday soon I get a split leaf. But really, really cute plant. I got the planter from Target. He likes a fairly bright room, but he doesn't like the sun to be on his leaves. And usually for him, I let his soil dry before I water him again. He likes a little bit of humidity, so I usually, the one downstairs, I have him on top of like pebbles with water, and that one's doing really, really well. This guy, I missed him, so, and he seems to be doing fine without the pebbles and with just misting. And this is supposed to be, this can be repotted every 2 years. It doesn't need to be potted all the time, and you want to repot him during the spring. Okay, love him. It's the first plant I have. This is, I think it's known as a rattlesnake calathea, I'm not sure. Really, really love his leaves. Let me just get my notes here. And his leaves are like this really dark, I don't know, is that like, it's like a purple, a dark purple color. Really, really pretty plant. And obviously tropical, and believe it or not, his leaves are not poisonous, which is crazy. Isn't he beautiful? And at night his leaves go up. It's, I guess it's kind of like similar to a prayer plant that the leaves come up at night. So for light, he likes bright indirect light, preferably a east, west, or north facing window. And same thing with him, he's sensitive to certain types of water, so I use distilled water on him or tap water that sat for a day. And he likes his soil to be moist but not soggy, and he likes a lot of humidity, so I've been misting him and we'll see how he does. So far he's okay. If I need to, I can put him on top of pebbles and see if he'll be happier that way. But so far, I'm not getting any brown leaves and he seems to be okay in his current condition. And so, yeah, I love him. This guy here. And I think he's known as a, what is he called? I think he's a zebra calathea, I'm not sure. And when I first picked him up, his leaves had been browning, and I think it's because of the water that I was using. So for him too, same thing as that guy there, he wants distilled water or water that's been sitting. I missed him also because he does like humidity, and he seems to be doing really, really well. It's the same care instructions as the other calathea. But he seems to be doing really well. If I need to, I'll also put him in pebbles, but for now he seems to be doing okay. And then I haven't seen any new growth on him yet, so we'll see. And then the pot I picked up at Home Goods. And then lastly is my, and you've been seeing him behind me in the frame, this is my peace lily. He hasn't bloomed yet, So we'll see how he does. I have plenty of new growth coming out and a few that are already unfolding. So I really, really love him. We'll see how he does under my care and see, hopefully he blooms for me. So I keep him in low to medium light. And I water him and I let the soil dry about 50% before I rewater him again. And they say to keep them pot bound because then they're more likely to bloom. So I haven't repotted him. I wanna just keep him in the pot and hopefully he'll bloom for me in the come spring and summer season. The leaves are poisonous, so you have to make sure you keep your pets away from him. But really, really pretty plant, and I can't wait for him to start blooming. He's so big, he's really a good size already. But he's just a pretty plant in general. Even without the blooms, he's just a really, really pretty plant. So that's all that I have for you guys today. If you enjoyed my video, then click the like button. And if you want to see more plant-related videos, then go ahead and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next video.